Hello students, we studied physical and chemical properties of matters and physical properties of non-matters. Now we are going to study how matters react with non-matters. First of all, matters. Matters are the elements which are having 1, 2 or 3 electrons in their outermost orbit. In order to acquire octet configuration, they will lose these electrons and form positive ions. So they are known as electropositive elements. Consider sodium. Sodium is the metal having atomic number 11 and its electronic configuration is 281. It is having one valence electron. So in order to acquire octet configuration, it will lose this electron and form positive ion Na+. You can see in the equation Na sodium having electronic configuration 281 forms Na+ ion having electronic configuration 28 and one electron is released. Another example for metals is magnesium, formation of magnesium ion. Next is non-metals. Non-metals are the elements which are having 5, 6 or 7 electrons in their outermost orbit. In order to acquire octet configuration, they will gain the electrons and they will form negative ions. So they are known as electronegative elements. For example, chlorine. Chlorine is having atomic number 17 and its electronic configuration is 281. So, in order to acquire octet configuration, it will gain the electron and form negative ion. You can see in the equation chlorine Cl having atomic number 17 and electronic configuration 287 gains one electron and forms chloride ion Cl- having electronic configuration 288. Another example for non-metals is oxide ion O-2. Next topic is formation of sodium chloride NaCl, which is formed between a metal sodium and non-metal chlorine. Sodium is having one valence electron, that is, it is having one electron in its outermost orbit, and you can see in the equation it is represented by a dot near Na. Chlorine, which is having seven electrons in its outermost orbit. This seven electrons are represented by cross around chlorine. And this type of structure is known as electron dot structure. Here you can see that sodium, we have already studied, sodium having configuration 281 loses one electron and forms sodium ion. This electron which is lost by the sodium is gained by chlorine in the formation of NaCl. And sodium chloride is formed by attraction between Na plus and Cl minus ions. So this type of compounds which are formed by transfer of electrons from a metal to a non-metal are known as ionic compounds or electrovalent compounds. Keep in mind that in ionic compounds, the electrons which are lost by metals are gained by non-metals, and the compound is formed due to attraction between a positive and negative ion. The example of such ionic compounds are magnesium chloride, calcium chloride, etc. Now we are going to study the formation of magnesium chloride. Magnesium having atomic number 12, its electronic configuration is 282. It will form magnesium ion Mg+2 by losing two electrons. And we know chlorine will gain one electron and form chloride ion Cl-. But here you can see that magnesium loses two electrons, but chlorine can gain only one electron. So in order to balance it, two chlorine atoms are taken. Each one will gain one electron, which is lost by magnesium, and magnesium chloride is formed due to attraction between Mg+2 and Cl- ion. So here you can see in the formula it is MgCl2 magnesium chloride, because two chlorine atoms are taken over here. Now we are going to study the property of such ionic compounds. First property is that ionic compounds are formed by transfer of electrons and they are made up of ions. We have studied in the examples we have seen earlier. Next is they are crystalline solids, means they are in the form of crystals. They are brittle. You can break it into pieces by applying pressure. Another property is they have high melting point and boiling point due to strong attraction between the ions. Another property is they are soluble in water but they are insoluble in organic solvents like petrol, kerosene, etc. The last property of ionic compounds is they can conduct electricity in molten state or in the solution. Since there is strong attraction between the ions, the ionic compound do not conduct electricity in their normal natural form, that is in the crystalline form, but they conduct electricity in molten state. When they are melted, the force of attraction between the ion reduces due to heat, and because of this the ions can move freely and they can conduct electricity. So they conduct electricity but in the molten state or in the solution. These are the properties of ionic compounds. You can refer page number 49 of your textbook to study them in detail. And as I already told, you have to write the answers of the blue questions which are given after each and every topic. Next is reactivity series of metals. Reactivity series is the series formed by arranging the metals in decreasing order of their reactivity. Displacement experiments are done and this reactivity series is made. You can see here that the most reactive metals are potassium, sodium, calcium, magnesium, whereas gold, silver, mercury are least reactive in nature. With the help of this reactivity series, we can study how and which metal will react in which way with different compounds. Next is occurrence of metal. Metals are obtained from earth crust. Metals like gold, silver, platinum are found in free state in earth crust because they are very less reactive. But the most of the metals which are reactive are found in the form of oxide. That is, they react with oxygen and form oxide. They react with carbon and form carbide. They react with sulfur and they form sulfides. And they react with halogen and form halides. These metals are obtained in three states from the earth crust. First of all, in the form of minerals which are occurring naturally inside the earth crust, in the form of ore. That is, ore is a mineral from which metal can be extracted profitably, means it contains maximum proportion of metal. Next is gangue. It is the impurity which is present in the ore, like rock particles, sand particle, etc. How to obtain these metals from their ores? For this, that is for extraction of metal from their ores, three methods are there. First of all, concentration of ore, next is reduction of metal, and another one is refining of metal. Concentration of ore means, first of all, the impurities which are there in the ore are removed by different methods. Next topic is the steps which are involved in extraction of metal from their ore. We are knowing that reactivity of different metals is different. First of all, if we take the metals of high reactivity like potassium, calcium, etc., they are obtained in their pure form by electrolysis of molten ore. Ore is melted, its electrolysis process is done, and pure metal is obtained. Next is metals of medium reactivity. They react with carbon and form carbonate ore, or either they react with sulfur and sulfide ore is obtained. Now the process of calcination is done if they are in the form of carbonate ore, and roasting is done if they are in the form of sulfide ore, and oxide of metal is obtained by both these processes. Then reduction is done. Reduction means removal of oxygen. You have already studied. So oxygen is removed and metal is obtained, and then its refining is done. Now the metals of low reactivity like gold, silver are obtained in the form of sulfide. The roasting process is done and a metal is obtained, and then its refining is done. So all these steps we are going to study in detail in the next topic.